Hi friends, viewers and subscribers. This situation can arrive in anybody's home because of cement repair, wall repair, in general ceiling repair and general use. This switch got contaminated with water in air in rainy season and regular use also can contaminate a switch because of various conductive elements. So this switch has become leaky. I'll show you how much it is leaking. It is giving considerable shock, not too much, but it was giving uncomfortable shock. See, this much it was leaking. So to avoid this or remove this problem, it can be done using solvent. See this, now I have kerosene and a brush to clean it. Brush must be sturdy, not too soft, otherwise it will not be able to scrape the dirt away. The dirt should be properly scraped and it should be allowed, kerosene should be allowed to make its effect by remaining it for some time. Clean it thoroughly. If necessary, you may have to open the switch. Even in spite of opening and doing anything, if the problem is not solved, it will be necessary to replace the switch. Replacing is easy. Remove these two screws, this one and this one, this box will come out. Then after removing this box from the wall, you can remove this switch by removing these two screws from this box. Then keep a new switch ready, fit it in this place and it will be all right. But for timing, I will try this for using kerosene and a brush like this. Now let it remain like this for some time to allow the kerosene to make its effect. Let's see how it solves the problem. See, this also switchboard has become contaminated and it has become quite dirty because of neglect and moisture in air. See, it has become black. This area especially has become contaminated and it is leaking. I'll show you it is leaking. See how much it is leaking. Now I'll use the same technique. I'll apply kerosene using a brush and keep it like that. And allow the kerosene to dissolve dust, dirt and conductive elements. See, it is flowing down. You keep it like this. You may need to apply this kerosene for some time. Let it dissolve and then apply the liquid again. Like this. Now we'll let the kerosene make its effect for some time and we'll come again. Now this is another switchboard which has been neglected and contaminated because of dust, dirt and regular use by very careless use. See, now I'm applying the same kerosene solution to this and allow it for some time. I may have to reapply kerosene if it evaporates. See, dirt is coming down, flowing down. You can see kerosene is making effect. Gradually it is getting cleaned. Because it was not giving good effect, kerosene was not giving good effect, so I had to add some thinner. Not dissolving properly, I added some auto paint thinner. See, this is the thinner. It is available in any paint store, surely. So I am applying it to the switch surface. Because thinner has higher volatility, it will dissolve all the contamination very quickly. See, like this. I will allow it to settle for some time along with kerosene, mixed it with kerosene and copper. This also switchboard. This switchboard also has been contaminated badly. Now you can see this thinner is acting fast and is removing all the dirt quickly. See. Now this dirt has become a sort of paste, and it is, you can see it here. Here also you can see. That means thinner is doing its job very well, and it is necessary to add thinner to kerosene to dissolve all this contamination around switches and clear them and avoid the shock problem. I'll let it work for some time. Sometime I'll apply kerosene again. I allowed thinner to work on this switch. You can see switch has become cleaner. Now some more kerosene I am allowing to dissolve dust or contamination further. I am working on live for a switch, it is not advisable, but because this liquid is not conductive, kerosene is not conductive, it is possible to work like this even the power is on. See, I am doing it online, but I am not advising or telling you, warning you not to do it online. You switch it off, switch off the power before you do anything. I am a practice electrician, I can handle situations like this, and it may be necessary at times to handle situation with this with power. You cannot switch off power at the middle of the night. Now I have applied kerosene again and I will allow it to rest for some time and let the dirt dissolve and come down. I told you I use kerosene and thinner. One thing you make sure that both liquid must never have any content of water in them. Otherwise, if water remains there, it will act as a conductive liquid and it will contaminate switch furthermore. It may give you shock also. You will have to be very careful to switch off power before you do anything like this. Whatever I have told you only about this surface leaking, switches are leaking and it may be giving little bit of shock or little bit of electrical vibration feel on your skin, sensitive skin. But if these screws are giving you shock and also terrible shock, that means these screws somehow because of some electrical mistake or open piece of wire touching these screws, it may be giving you severe shock. In that case, it is very dangerous to allow this situation. You get an electrician, that also qualified and willing electrician, to solve the problem. He will have to find where it is touching, how it is touching, and he will have to properly dress the wire so that it will not touch any of these screws and give you shock. So make sure you get a good person to do this, handle this problem. See, this liquid has come down, kerosene and thinner has evaporated, now it has brought whatever contamination down. Now I am wiping it with some rag or cloth which is clean, dry, and it is necessary that this piece of cloth should not be conductive in the first place, otherwise it will add to the contamination. What is the use? So be very careful what you are doing, No, understand what you're doing first, and then only you do it. Do it at your own risk, and otherwise get an electrician to do it. Like this. You can do it yourself, but you will have to be very careful, and you can do it only by understanding how to do it. Okay. While doing this work, is one very good precaution, safety precaution you can do. You can wear definitely insulating, that is dry footwear, before doing this work, so that even if it causes some sort of leakage or some electrical conduction and it comes into contact with your finger, you should not get electrocuted. So basic precaution to handle this work yourself is to wear dry and definitely insulating footwear. Be sure of it. See, after this, after doing all this maintenance or attempting to clear this leakage problem, you can see the tester is not showing any light. That means it has solved the problem. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe if you like it.